Hey guys, so I got a special treat for you. I'm doing my first ever Rolling Stone song on Kendra Reacts. I know. It seems like that should have been like my first suggestion. Yeah, I agree. But it's better late than never. This actually comes off Jay-Z's 500 Greatest Songs of All Time, an article he did for the Rolling Stone magazine. Apparently, this is his 498th favorite song. I do know this song. It's been in a lot of movies, and it's very 70-ish. Maybe it's that's because it came out in 1978. Or the album did, at least, which is called Some Girls. If you don't know what I'm talking about the track Miss You. So, let's get into it. We got Mick Jagger. What else can I say? The man literally has the moves like Jagger. So let's do it. This is the Rolling Stones, Miss You, from the album Some Girls. Okay, so 53 seconds in, I'm like, do you know it now? Come on, the ooh has to have given it away. It's so 70-ish that it makes me want to do 70s dance moves, which I probably will end up doing and embarrassing myself. But they're the Rolling Stones. I say that with emphasis. That means worth it to make a fool of myself, because they're like top three greatest band of all time. I only say top three because people argue, and I don't want them to be arguing under my posts. In my books, Mick Jagger is probably the greatest frontman of all time. And the fact that he still does at his age, the man definitely still has the moves like Jagger. You go, Mick. You go. He always sounds like he's talking in a song. Maybe not always, but in a song like this that has a very upbeat tone and tempo, he always seems like he comes around like he's having a conversation with somebody. And yet he sounds so good while doing it. It's effortless. Like his tone, And I can already picture him in my head strutting his stuff, like down the street. And he's like, "What's up, baby? How you doing?" Because, you know, that's what Mick Jagger did in the 70s, at least in my head. That's probably what Mick Jagger does in the 2020s, at least in my head. I don't know. Mick Jagger, let me tell you about this man. His kid is like 4 years old. She's younger than his granddaughter. His great-granddaughter. So, you cannot tell me the man still ain't got it. The man's got it. But, I mean, you listen to it and you listen to him. And Mick, he can work a song, he can work a crowd. He can work a stage. So, I really want to, like, find this song live. Because I can just see him pointing to somebody in the crowd and saying this, talking to them as if he's having a conversation. Expected that went from him like talking, mumbling and whatever to him kind of going up really high, and then here comes the saxophone and it's like, okay. But that's what makes the Rolling Stones great. Mick is a great front man. Like, you have to have that. But the fact that the pieces around him are also fantastic is why they have been so long and so just so successful in the long run. I mean, I don't even know how long they've been doing it together. And I'm sure, you know, not all of them are the same as it was when they started, except probably Mick. I don't know. I don't know who all the members of the Rolling Stones are. That's probably bad of me. Considering the fact that I'm a huge Rolling Stones fan. I forgot to mention them when I said, oh, I grew up on Guns N' Roses and AC/DC. I forgot to say the Rolling Stones too. If you would ask me my favorite Rolling Stones song, it would be Beast of Burden. That's my favorite Rolling Stones song, and do not ask me why I'm not doing it, because it would be really embarrassing me. I would probably get up and start singing it and dancing like, not like Mick Jagger at all. But that's what makes the Rolling Stones great, because you get that emotion, that feeling, that comfort of them. And I feel comfortable enough that on camera I'm over here doing all these 70s moves. Because I'm imagining in my head that that's what people did in a club listening to this song. And you cannot tell me that if they played this in a club today, your ass would not get up and dance to it. Because you know you would. It's got that much of a groove to it all these years later. I'm just saying. That's how impressive the Rolling Stones and Mick Jagger are. Curious for the older people who watch my channel. I know you're out there because I got a comment from an older woman from an older song. What was your go-to dance move back in the day? And don't act like you didn't have one. Everyone had one. Like, I would love to have like really high hair like Dolly Parton. I'd love to have a waist like Dolly Parton. Not the breast, though, because I can't handle that. But the waist and some bell-bottom jeans. And I'd be out there grooving to this song. I know people have grooved to this song. This song is groovy. It's hashtag groovy. I'm actually going to put that in the title. Hashtag groovy reaction to Miss You by the Rolling Stones. Totally. That's how. And I don't even care. Y'all can pretend. Like, I don't know. I didn't do that. Yeah, you did. Everybody does it. Everybody does it now. So why wouldn't you have done it back then, whenever the music was so much better than what it is now? Yeah, I said it. Spotify was trying to get me. They always be trying to get me. I try to stop it at 4:48. Thing goes right into the next song. I'm sorry. I love Rolling Stones, but I'm not ready to listen to When the Whip Comes Down. That is a very interesting title, though. Awkward pause. Okay. That was fun. I give Jay-Z props. Like, fist bump, homie. Me and you, eye to eye with that song. He knows. He probably grooves to it, too. Him and B. Can't you see it? Jay-Z and Beyonce up in their mansion? Grooving to Miss You by the Rolling Stones? I totally can. If you can't, you have no imagination. Or you're no fun at all. I enjoyed that. I'm definitely going to do more Rolling Stones, personally, because I want to. If you didn't enjoy that, you need to get your head checked, because that song is jamming. Okay, I need to stop using lingo. It doesn't work for me. I'll be back. Let's see what I can cook up next. Later, guys.